Hello everyone, this is the second online tutorial video for class 9. The subject is history. We are continuing the chapter the French Revolution from the previous video. We are doing the second segment, the revolution, how the revolution was set up. Now, as we know from the previous video, King Louis XVI has to increase the taxes in order to fill the treasury of France. Now, the king, the monarch of France, did not have the power to impose these reforms directly, impose these reforms straight away. He had to call a meeting of the Estates General. The Estates General would then pass his proposals for new taxes. The Estates General was a political body to which three estates could send their representatives. We discussed about the three estates in the previous video. However, the king can only decide when the Estate General meeting can be called. On 5th May 1789, Louis XVI called the meeting. Voting in the Estate General in the past has been conducted according to the principle that each estate had one vote. This time also, the king was determined to hold up the same traditional rule, but members of the third estate wanted that instead of the rule that each estate had one vote, it should be reformed to this rule that each member of the Estate General had one rule. When the king rejected this offer, the members of the third estate walked out as a protest. On 20th June, they assembled in the hall of an indoor tennis ground in the Versailles. They declared themselves a national assembly. They swore not to disperse until they had drafted a constitution for France. The constitution would aim at limiting the powers of the monarch, limiting the powers of the king, reducing the powers effectively of Louis XVI. When the National Assembly was busy drafting the constitution, the rest of the France was in very much chaos. A severe winter had meant a very bad harvest, crop production is low, the price of bread and food grains have rose up, spending hours in long queues at the bakery, the people have started becoming restless and angry. Crowds of angry women stormed the shops, they broke all the shops, they looted the food grain items, and at the same time, the king ordered troops to move into Paris. The king sent his soldiers to stop these people. On 14th July, the angry crowd, the angry people of France, stormed and destroyed the Bastille prison. Now, why did they choose to destroy Bastille prison? Because Bastille prison was, in their mindset, Bastille prison was a symbol of oppression which was run by the king. So, destroying the Bastille prison means directly challenging the power of the king, hence storming the Bastille prison. Facing imminent rebellion from the subject, Louis XVI finally accepted the constitution drafted by the National Assembly and accepted the principle that his powers from now on will be very much reduced. On the night of 4th August 1789, the Assembly passed a decree abolishing the feudal system. Members of the clergy, that is the first order, the first estate, the members of the clergy, the first estate, and members of the royalty, that is the second estate, their rights, their privileges were confiscated. Church lands were confiscated. So these all confiscated money, amount of money, added to the royal treasury. Now we look at the constitution which was drafted by the National Assembly. Its main objective was, as we have discussed, limiting the power of the king. These powers, instead of being concentrated into the one hand of the king, now is being distributed into different departments: the legislature, the executive, and the judiciary. This made France a constitutional monarchy. The king exists, but he has to follow the rules set up by the constitution. The Constitution of 1791, the Constitution of 1791 vested the power to make laws in the National Assembly, which was indirectly elected. That is, citizens, the common citizens, would vote for a group of electors. Now, the electors would then elect the National Assembly. But all the citizens did not have the right to vote, remember. Only men above 25 years of age who had paid taxes to at least 3 days equal of a laborer's wage, they were given the right to vote. The Constitution began with the Declaration of the Rights of Man and Citizen. Rights such as the right to life, freedom of speech, freedom of opinion, equality before law were established as the natural and inalienable rights. That is, they belong to each human being by birth and could never be taken away. It was the duty of the state, it was the duty of the government to protect each citizen's natural rights. So I'm going to stop here. In the next tutorial video, we are going to learn about Robespierre and the Reign of Terror. Till then, bye.